Hi, and welcome to this B1UP Tips and Tricks session. Today, we will look at how to get rid of annoying pop-ups, which is also called auto-press next pop-up. So let's jump into Business One and have a look at what that's all about. So SAP have actually fixed this in 9.3 a bit, but not entirely. So the pop-ups I'm talking about is, for example, if you choose another sales employee, it will ask if you want to update existing rules. In many cases, you just want it to always say yes or always say no, depending on your business scenario. But in this case, SAP have fixed it by saying you have the option to remember and don't show this message again. So that's all good and well, but they have not put that option into every single place you could do. For example, when you add an invoice, it will still ask you, are you really, really sure you want to do this? Might be a fair warning for novices, but for experts, of course, you know that the AI invoice will not be changed. So this is just in your way. So let's get rid of this one. Again, the other ones SAP can handle, but the ones they can't handle, let us take care of it. So what we need to do is we need to right-click the Add button and say, whenever before SAP press this button, let's do something. So let's call it get rid of pop-up. And we don't really need to do anything over here. But look, we are doing it before SAP. So actually before the pop-up is shown. The pop-up will be shown after SAP have registered the add button. And that's because this needs to happen before the message is shown. It's a little counterintuitive, but that's because of the way the event flows inside SAP. So we need to simply have a macro that says auto press next pop-up. You can see we have different options. Right now we only want to press the yes button, and that's the default button. So we don't really need to tell which button it is, but if we wanted to press the no button all the time, doesn't make sense in this scenario, we could actually go in and tell among the two buttons, which of them should be pressed, one for yes, two for zero. But in our case, we just want to press the default button, which is the yes button. So if we do that, we should be able to go in and have this running. So let me add this validation. And before, when I press the add, I got the, are you sure, yes, no. When I press it now, I don't get it at all, and the system just works as expected. So again, in almost every case, you can get rid of this, but again, you need to do it in an event that happens before the message box actually appear. Not after, because it's not like it's saying, when this box is here, press it, because then our code can't run because it's actually waiting for that message. So we need to tell it before, in order to do anything. And if you have cases where you only sometimes get a message and other times don't, there's actually a timeout built into the system that if it doesn't detect a new pop-up within the next 5 seconds, it will just ignore the reply. So it's not like you by mistake press the next again after that. So with that, thank you for attending, and I hope it was beneficial.